return to your senses in Florida.
Of all the cities in the world, only one was built on family fun. It's like no other city on the planet. Call today for your free vacation guide.
Last year, St. Peter's backcourt general Michael Friendsley led the Peacocks to the big dance. But this year, they want more. The question is, when they take on perennial power Kansas, will they be able to handle the likes of Rafe LaFrance and Scott Pollard down low? The action stays hot when George Washington plays last year's NIT champ Virginia Tech. The Colonials will have to keep their cool because Tech has an ace in the hole. St. Peter's versus Kansas at 7:30. George Washington versus Virginia Tech at 9:30. Monday, NCAA Hoops on ESPN2.
In case you missed it the first time, write it down, Big Monday. We've got Villanova and Connecticut, Kansas, Oklahoma State, Fresno State. Tim Tima on for, I think it's his first shift.
Yeah, Tima, the all-time league leader in penalty minutes, blocks, and games played.
One of two players to have played every season this league has been in existence.
I tell you, if the NPSL ever forms a Hall of Fame, Tim Tima will be the first name you see inducted.
Chuck Codd with the ball. He was traded for a very popular player from this team. Tony Bono off to Chicago in exchange for Chuck Codd. Left footer from Vincent Peck.
And a
block at the defense. And we'll head down to Greg Bates in the stands. What do you got for us, Greg?
You're the owner of the Cleveland Crunch, George Hoffman. You got your former coach down there, Gary Hindley. How do you feel about playing Gary now that he's left you?
I don't have any feelings one way or the other. He's the coach. He's coaching for them now. We have Bruce Miller, and he's doing an excellent job for us. I don't blame Gary for trying to advance himself. That's good for him.
Is there any strong feeling of resentment or whatever toward this franchise? They tried to get Hector Marinaro from you. They wanted to pay a lot of money for him.
Hey, it makes me feel good that someone wants to pay a lot of money to me. I'll take it any day of the week.
You're very involved. You're very passionate about the game. Do you react differently than the fans? I mean, it's your team here on the line. I see you're watching, obviously.
Yeah, well, I want to see if they get a goal in, that's all. Yeah, it's hard to do an interview when you're watching your team playing. But I think that Gary's an excellent coach, and he will build this franchise. He'll make something out of it. That's good. It's good for the league. Yeah, it's good that one team dominates. I think that that's great.
All right, George, thanks. Good luck.
All right, thank you.
Thanks, Chris.
George Hoffman,
a foul against the Silverbacks gives Cleveland a restart outside the D, and this is where the Crunch is very, very dangerous.
And George said he wants to see a goal. And a good chance here on the restart for Cleveland.
Zoran Karic had 104 assists two seasons ago. Oh, the head ball by Tima didn't get it all. It's knocked in by Doug Miller. Doug Miller on the follow-up, a two-point goal. The Crunch has taken a 4-2 lead.
Now, one of the big keys tonight for Cincinnati is to not give Cleveland too many restarts. And the second restart goal of the night for Cleveland as Karic played the ball in for Tima in the box. Tima flicked it on with his head, but it came right back out to Miller. And that's virtually the same place that Dostoski scored from the first goal. And Miller that time with his 33rd two-point goal.
There were three Crunch attackers behind the Cincinnati defense there. And Karic, who is so deadly and threading the needle. Look out, here's Blakeman, right footer just over the bar.
And exactly, at Karic with the hard shot. You've got to put three men out there to guard against the shot, and he'll pick you apart with the pass.
The Crunch is so good at playing early balls. Here's Doug Miller, left footer just over the bar. Schmetzer tries to get on the rebound. It's cleared by Blakeman, and he's running with Mark Thomas. Cross carpet, Thomas couldn't get a shot off the back track, and Glenn Carbonera able to get a foot on. Medved tries it from the D.
Yeah, you saw Carbonera come back and make a good play defensively there. And he's a guy that you don't hear a whole lot about during the course of the season, but is always a steady player in the back for the Crunch.
14:09, the time of Doug Miller's goal from Zoran Karic, and there's the horn. 15 minutes, our history at the Cincinnati Gardens. Doug Miller, the latest goal. He's only 3 points away from his career high. And we'll take a break. Back for the second half after this.
Feel the heat. Catch balls of fire. Call 1-800-80-KICKS for the only scorching soccer action available on home video. Get ready to smash, crash, and score with balls of fire. No soccer fan can afford to miss this sensational home video. Cheer on the heart-pounding plays, the greatest goals, the wildest kicks, and all the outrageous antics of the game as you've never seen it before. Call 1-800-80-KICKS now for Balls of Fire, the hottest, fastest, and most intense sports video you'll find. Don't miss your chance to experience all the blazing action, cool moves, and explosive entertainment of NPSL soccer. Get Balls of Fire for only $14.95 plus shipping and handling. All major credit cards accepted. This video is available only through this exclusive TV offer. If you like your sports action fast, serious, and fun, call 1-800-80-KICKS now. Balls of Fire. Catch it.
Like a lot of other people, Alexi Lalas runs to work. The only difference is that when Alexi gets there, he doesn't have to change. Half running shoe, half soccer shoe. The equipment number 6 trainer from Adidas.
Whopper, 99 cents. Get your burger's worth.
For the best in soccer gear and accessories, call for the Euro Pro Sport catalog at 1-800-934-3876. That's Eurosport. 1-800-934-3876. Let's check in with Greg Mace.
You know, Ed North, there's always a great rivalry between the cities of Cincinnati and Cleveland. And it was perhaps never more apparent than in 1991. It was during a Browns-Bengals football game. The fans were throwing things on the field, and Bengals coach Sam Weiss took the microphone.
Well, the next person that sees anybody throw anything onto this field, point them out, and get them out of here. You don't live in Cleveland!
Rivalry between these two teams. Perhaps it's going to continue to heat up. It's certainly not the Browns and Bengals yet, but maybe eventually it will be, Ed.
Great stuff, Greg. Here comes Doug Miller attacking. He had a goal in that first quarter. As we begin the second quarter, the teams will switch sides. Cincinnati in their home whites. Cleveland with the red, black, red combination. Gutierrez tries to find Miller. Up ahead, you know, Doug Miller, Henry Gutierrez, they're both about 5'8". Schweitzer's not more than 5'10". I keep picturing them play against the trees in St. Louis. This is Spencer. He scores! Andy Spencer with a left-footer puts the crunch up 4 at 6-2. It comes 39 seconds into the second quarter.
And just as you mentioned, that line, they provide us with a goal. And as I said before, probably the top second line in all of the NPSL, and you see Schmetzer there with the finish. And that's twice now Cincinnati has come out at the beginning of the game and now at the beginning of the second quarter and given up a goal just seconds in.
A lot of the big guns at Cleveland have been hurt this year. Hector's missed a lot. Zoran's missed a lot. Andy Schmetzer has stepped up and been one of the go-to guys. He was the NPSL Player of the Week around Christmas time, and he was the key and the biggest comeback of the year for the Crunch, and we'll get to that. As the Cincinnati Silverbacks attack. The Crunch was down 11-0 in that game. They came back to win it on a goal by Andy Schmetzer, and he had a hat trick in that game. There's the quick outlet, 2-on-1. Trouble for Cincinnati, but they recover well. Karen shoots and scores!
goal by the Z-Man as he took Chucky Codd to school that time to his Blakeman. He cut Blakeman inside out and then buried it in the lower corner with the left foot.
That comes at 107.
And watch the cut move there by Carriage and then a bullet into the lower corner as Cleveland has struck twice early here in the second quarter.
And once again, that's that early ball out of the backs, bringing the numbers up counterattacks. And a timeout taken down on the floor.
Actually, it wasn't Codd or Blakeman. It was Lyndon Hooper, the man that scored the Cincinnati goal, who was taken to school that time by the Z-Man.
We'll take a break as the crunch lead has blown to six. We'll be back.
Play with the soccer ball of the pros, Kendis, the official soccer ball of the National Professional Soccer League. Guaranteed for long-lasting high performance. Hand-stitched for superior quality, uniquely designed. Kendis, the soccer ball of the pros. Available at soccer specialty stores everywhere. When soccer is the game, Kendis is the name. Kendis, the official soccer ball of the National Professional Soccer League. Kendis for your team or league. A soccer ball that's one kick ahead of all the others.
Introducing the $16,000 BMW. Presenting the $16,000 Lexus. Behold, the $16,000 Mercedes. To everyone who thought it was impossible to build an affordably priced luxury car, we have just one thing to say. Take a seat. The Nissan Altima. Now own an Altima for zero down, zero APR financing, and no payments until April.
On January 26th, the silence will be shattered.
Call it a screamer.
Where are they coming from?
Underground.
From the author of Blade Runner and Total Recall.
We got a new kind of screamer.
They're smarter now.
Get out of here!
There's too many of them. It's useless! Hang on!
Screamers. Rated R. At theaters, January 26th.
Time for the NHL. So when they ice it, hook it, save it, stick it, stop it, play it, and score it. You'll need to know. NHL Tonight on ESPN2. News, features, and highlights. Sports Center for the hockey addict. Tuesday through Saturday at 11:30 p.m. As the clock winds down, the season heats up on ESPN2.
Due to time constraints, we'll move ahead in the action between the Crunch and the Silverbacks. Vincent Beck had his biggest offensive output last season with 63 points and a Dayton Dynamo uniform. Steve Provin, second leading scorer for the Silverbacks. Dusaski nipping away, finally came away with it. This guy's only 19 years old, folks. Spent part of a year at a Division III college in Wisconsin. Chuck Codd has been the steadiest defender for Cincinnati since coming over from Chicago. Codd in his fifth season. Actually was a college teammate of Tommy Tanner, who's not in uniform for the Crunch this evening because of a hamstring injury.
And a tough call that time on Codd, as it looked like he got the ball. Now a blue card's gonna come out. I believe it may be for dissent.
I don't think there was a penalty on the initial call. It was a foul, no question. Chuck Codd, 28 years old, out of Torrance, California. Spent 4 years prior to this with the Chicago Power. Alcala will get a penalty here for, I believe, unsportsmanlike conduct.
No. Cleveland will be on the power play. Cincinnati is going to have to play a man short for the unsportsmanlike conduct. And a good matchup here. Cleveland's power play, number one in the league. And Cincinnati comes in the top man down unit.
Now, if the crunch scores in the next 2 minutes, it's worth 1 point. They are on the power play. Cincinnati still can score 2 point and 3 point goals, being a man down. The Silverbacks have given up only three shorthanded goals this season. There you see that they rate that Cleveland scores with a man up and the rate that Cincinnati defends with a man down.
Yeah, Cincinnati special teams have been very good. First in the man down and fourth on the man up. Attribute that to good coaching.
Very patient are the crunch. Andy Schmitzer, the team captain, wearing the armband. Unsportsmanlike conduct was the penalty. Here's Schmitzer, right footer, is blocked at the defense by Todd. Vincent Beck luckily got it to the foot of Chuck Todd. Lyndon Hooper off. He's got a shot to Hoop go up. And take it down from behind by Scott Schweitzer. Lyndon is looking for a penalty call. What a run that was.
Well, smart play by Cincinnati to get Scotty Cannon off on the man down. Lyndon Hooper comes on offensively, and that time from behind, Schweitzer came and just clipped Hooper's leg from the back. Now, Cincinnati's going to have a free kick yet, but they need to be careful they don't get everybody into the attack and get countered the other way.
Once again, Sean Medved at the controls. Tried to play it across. Miller read it well. And Carriage will get it back. 55 seconds to go in the crunch power play. Zoran Karic with 12 one-point goals this season. He has hit the century mark in points already. With three tonight, he has 103. Gutierrez into Miller. He tried to play it across. That got busted up. Crunch with 30 seconds to go on the power play. Carriage tries a long ranger. Pop, Jeff Pop got a piece of it. Miller swatted away by Pena. And a foul called in the corner against Cleveland.
Good save that time by Pena to go up with the left hand, with the right hand actually, and tip it to the side.
Carlos Pena was the rookie of the year back in 1988-89. Second team All-Pro that season as well. His brother Danny, very good professional soccer player.
And a penalty over as Cincinnati's leading man down team shuts down a Cleveland power play.
And the Silverbacks attack. They trail by four. We're just over halfway through the second quarter. Battle between Gutierrez and Alcala. There's the give and go. Alcala's left foot. Otto with the stop. Got it across the goal mouth and a foul called against Cincinnati.
Good reaction save that time by Otto. As you see from close range, Otto gets that right hand up there as Alcala came streaking through the middle. I played with Jeff Alcala in Chicago. He was a teammate of Chuck Kahn and myself. Quick young player, recently added to the team. Should give him some speed in the midfield.
Otto dumps it deep. Cannon tries to beat Marinero there. Does so momentarily and then wins the ball. But he ran into Todd Dasaski. Who had the ball stripped by Medved. Here's Sean with some space. Cross carpet Cannon. Open on the near side is Hooper, but the pass behind. Now Medved, right footer, it's in the seats. And with that, we'll take a break. The crunch with a 4-point lead over the Silverbacks. We're in the second quarter.
A shoe for us.
Damn.
A
like a lot of other people, Alexi Lalas runs to work. The only difference is that when Alexi gets there, he doesn't have to change. Half running shoe, half soccer shoe. The equipment number 6 trainer from Adidas.
Pool, the Master's Way, and Learn from the Best. Two of America's favorite instructional videos are now available only through this special TV offer. Get tips from Steve Misurak, Pretty Boy Floyd, Iwo Mataya, and other pool greats. Now, for a limited time, you can order both videos for the price of one. Learn the secrets of breaks, banks, defense, position, angles, and trick shots, like the Massé and the Jump.
Take it from me, the Miz. When you purchase Pool the Master's Way and Learn from the Best, you'll learn everything you need to know how to shoot pool like a pro. With these two tapes, you can do almost anything except beat me.
World champion Steve Misurak takes you through the best ways to improve your game. Call the number on your screen and we'll send you this wonderful two-video cassette collection for just $19.95 plus postage and handling.
Two for the price of one? How can you go wrong?
These videos have never been offered together and are only being offered for a limited time. Call now. Have your credit card ready. An operator is waiting for your call. Sorry, no CODs. Call now.
There's the score. The crunch by 4. And a team, a hoop team that plays in this very building right here, the Xavier Musketeers, will be on the road to take on the Temple Owls. That's Atlantic 10 Conference Basketball coming up. Xavier with their former MCC Freshman of the Year for TJ Johnson. We're back to action. This is Todd DeSusky. Todd signed a developmental contract, but they're going to have to sign him to a regular contract because he has hit the 20-game mark in today's game. And under the developmental contracts, you can only play 20 games. So Todd has taken advantage of some big opportunities and come through huge. Marinaro is broken up by Todd. They break out 2-on-1 if Cincinnati hurries. Medved and Thomas coming in on Tima. The backtrack run from Dragicevic. He makes the block. Here's a look at the top of the table and scores. Top 4 wear red.
No surprise there. Franklin McIntosh, the player of the month in 2 of the 3 months this season for Baltimore, has had an outstanding start.
34-year-old Zoran Karic, he still addresses defender after defender. Hooper! Oh, he had an opening.
Well, you mentioned the Z-man, and he has scored the cycle at 9 times in his career in the NPSL, the cycle being a 3-point goal, 2-point goal, 1-point goal, and an assist in the same game. And you know, he did it 2 years ago to this date against Wichita, came back the next night against Kansas City and scored the cycle again.
Well, let me tell you, you fans are lucky to see something you just saw, and that's Zoran Karic's smile during a soccer game. Normally he has that sneer and that growl, but I think he's enjoying himself a little bit more this season.
I really felt one of the keys for Cleveland was that they keep their emotions in check tonight. You've seen Zoran in the past get it upset in games, and that's when Cleveland has faltered.
Here's Cannon trying to cut around. Alcala stepped in. You know what? I think one of the reasons that Karic is having such a good time is because Bruce Miller, the head coach, let's see.
I haven't seen him smile there, Ed.
No, he wasn't smiling. I lied. There he is. You know, I think the reason he's smiling, as I was saying, is Bruce Miller has kind of said to the young players, go talk to Zoran. You know, he's given the veterans a lot of input. They've said their piece. This is how we want it. And Miller said, okay. You know, and when he's had to step in, he has. And Zoran feels more of a leader now, I think, than he has in the past.
Well, when you see good young players, Ed, there's usually some good veterans on the team that go along with that. And you see one of the veterans, Tim Tima, take down his ex-teammate, Sean Medved. And Tima with a desperation, very close to being 2 minutes that time.
Medved again. Trying to curl it through and hit high off the glass.
And He can't touch that ball again because it didn't hit another player.
Quickly restarted by the crunch. This is a very quick second line. Gutierrez blocked by Vincent Beck. Vincent Beck coming up on the all-time leaders and blocked. And we're going to have a two-minute penalty against the crunch.
Henry Gutierrez behind the play. It was, but Richard Herron saw Gutierrez flick his legs and take down Jeff Alcala. Now watch Gutierrez behind the play. Well, might have been a little bit of an acting job there by Alcala, but nonetheless, Cincinnati's going to have a shootout, and Gutierrez is going to go to the sin bin.
Sean Medved, 5 of 6 on the shootouts. It's 5 seconds, 1v1 against the goalkeeper.
And Medved, you see the 5 for 6, that really leads the league. There's a couple other guys that are 1 for 1, but unless you've taken a few shootouts, you shouldn't be credited for it. And Medved, a phenomenal percentage.
Otto Warp sets on the line.
And I'm sure these two have taken some shootouts against each other when Medved played for the crunch, when they practiced together.
Comes in slowly, surveys, uses the boards, and scores!
That time by Medved, it was when he touched the ball, it was almost as if they're staring at each other, saying, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? And Medved pushes it off the board. Ball hopped up a little bit on him off the board, but he...
That's how high he got to get over this ball.
That ball, when it hits that yellow strip, sometimes has a tendency to pop up, and Medved stayed right on top of it.
Sean's 8 1-point goal of the season. And now Cincinnati goes to the power play, which they are ranked number 3 in the league behind Cleveland and St. Louis. Cincinnati scoring at a 47% rate.
And for a 4-11 team, those numbers are very good on both power play. We also mentioned their league-leading man-down team.
You know what? Gary Henley, who is very into numbers, can't figure out how he is 4-11 when you look at some of the statistics up and down his lineup.
Well, I'll tell you how. He's lost 5 games by 2 points or less, so that's why they are 4-11.
Yeah, their fourth quarters haven't been real good. Now, Cleveland's record on the other side, 17-2, but Art, take a look at some of these numbers.
Well, they've had a very favorable schedule. They've beaten up on expansion Tampa Bay 4 times, Canton and Chicago 10-0. Against the other 3 teams that are in the playoff in their division, Buffalo, Baltimore, and Harrisburg, they're only 500. So the tough part of their schedule still is in front of them.
Definitely worked out for new head coach Bruce Miller, who definitely came in under some pressure to win right away. I mean, he was handed some very talented soccer players. 40 seconds to go on this power play for Cincinnati. Medved, 28 years old, out of Seattle. This is Blakeman, strong left foot. Pushed back to the midfield by Andy Schmetzer. Cincinnati showing some patience.
But both teams taking too many touches on their power play. You need to make some one-time passes to split the defense.
Early ball, it's going to hop into the arms of Carlos Pena as Dougie Miller hustles back into the play. Man advantage almost over. Give and go. Medved just out of his tracks. Now Proben, the penalty is over, so now if they score, it's worth 2 points. But Todd Dasoski stepped in. Blakeman, to his right, stepped into a double team. Dasoski cleared it. Todd and Troy Dasoski actually played high school soccer for Bruce Miller, who was an assistant coach at that high school at the time. And that's how they wound up.
It's nice to know someone, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
It'll get you places.
Lyndon Hooper with the quickness.
And the crowd, every time Hooper touches the ball, yell, "Hoop!" They love him here in Cincinnati. And they certainly love him tonight as he's already scored 2 goals.
Down to 1:20 to go in the quarter. Crunch hanging on to a three-point lead after they had opened up a six-point lead at one time early in this quarter. A foul called against Cleveland. It'll give Cincinnati the free kick deep. The assistant coach getting the foul.
And the assistant coach is a little worried because Cincinnati has had the momentum here the last 3 or 4 minutes, down only 3 with a minute 10 left. They get one more here, they'll have a lot of confidence going in at halftime.
Mark Thomas will call a timeout. Clock stops with a minute 10. And we've got more indoor action coming up for you right here. But this is the Mill, the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. The New York Saints and the Rochester Nighthawks. The Nighthawks with their first team All-Pro, Paul Gate. The Saints finished last year and trying to rebound. Here's what the rest of the month will look like in the NPSL. St. Louis, Kansas City, Baltimore, Buffalo, and St. Louis, Cleveland.
Some great games there on the Deuce. And next week, St. Louis at Kansas City. And what defense Kansas City has been playing this year. They've held their opponent under 10 points in the last 4 games.
And we'll head out to the crowd and try and find Greg Mace. Greg, where are you at?
This is an historic old building. It opened in 1949, Ed and Art, and it's got a great atmosphere. Perhaps the most famous guy that ever played here was a basketball player, the Big O, Oscar Robertson, who, of course, was with the old Cincinnati Royals. They renovated this building a number of times, but it still certainly serves its purpose. There's an International Hockey League team here, Xavier University, and the crowd, I think, is terrific. Cincinnati seems to be warming up to indoor soccer. It's a good crowd. As we said, it's an intimate atmosphere, and I think Oscar Robertson will be proud of these guys.
Well, Thomas is going to try to take a page out of Oscar Robertson's book here and make an assist.
Times before Andy Schmetzer is able to get it up the boards. Miller's going to have to hold off a mark. Now less than a minute to play in the quarter.
I really believe this half is going to give Cincinnati a lot of confidence going in at halftime, and they've played the crunch well.
Back shot blocked by Marinaro. Back dumped it in. That's going to be over and back. Hitting a crunch player, and it'll give Cincinnati a free kick down here at the yellow line.
And we've seen Vincent Beck unleash a couple three-point shots in the last couple shifts. He's going to be down on the right side this time, and look for the Silverback to possibly set him up. Actually going down low.
Medved once again will trigger. Shot cannon. Cincinnati has been very unlucky in curling these balls down just over the crossbar. Once again, this time Blakeman.
They're just leaning back a little bit, and you got to stay over the ball. And that's why 3 or 4 times in this half, the ball is it just over the bar.
Mark Thomas against the double team. Not yet. Now Thomas steps in, nicked it away. Thomas came away with it. His shot blocked. 10 seconds to play in the first half. Medved tried to make Thomas, and Thomas will be called for the foul, even though he might have caught a ball.
And the former teammates, Tima and Medved, and, you know, Timmy's a smart player. I'm sure this is just a way to try to fire up his team. He feels they're a little sluggish at this point. And Cincinnati's bringing a sixth attacker on for this final 4.5. You see, Tima, he felt he got hit, but Gary Hindley's put a sixth attacker on. Nobody to the goal to our left.
And Steve Proven in the goalkeeper's jersey.
And good, quick thinking on the part of Gary Hindley to get that sixth attacker on, give you one more option off this restart.
Sean Blakeman, he of the left foot. For Medved, he got under it again. Aren't all these guys are leaning back?
Yeah, if there's one thing that Gary Hindley can tell his troops at halftime, is keep the ball on target. You have no chance to score unless you hit the target. Now, Carlos Pena is going to come back into the goal with 3 seconds left. But Cincinnati has had the chances.
Without a doubt. And with that, we'll get the horn for halftime. Good battle going on in the Gardens in our first game of the season. And the Crunch with an 8-5 lead. the Silverbacks.
This free video shows you how Bowflex lets you outperform Nordic Flex and Soloflex. Call for yours right now. You need to see this free video. Bowflex lets me perform the strength aerobic workout I want in 20 minutes. It's quick, it's easy, and it makes my body feel incredible. There's simply nothing else like it. You can change the amount of weight you're using by adding more power rods. The cable pulley system accommodates 64 different exercises. It's even backed by a lifetime warranty. If you're like me, and at first you looked at machines like Soloflex and Nordic Flex, you've got to see what Bowflex can do for you. It simply produces results. Call right now for this free 15-minute video. It will show you exactly how Bowflex will let you outperform Soloflex and Nordic Flex. You'll be surprised at how effective Bowflex really is. If you want to see the easiest, most effective way of exercising at home, you need to see this video. It's absolutely free, so call for yours right now.
Floating around here in the gardens, it's the blimp. And the blimp's been watching one heck of an NPSL battle between Cleveland and Cincinnati in the crunch with a slight edge after 30 minutes of play. A lot of familiarity between these two sides, former teammates. They started going at it late between team and Medved. And when the whistle blew and the horn sounded, it didn't end, Art.
Yeah, and look at Gary Huber, the referee, having to pull a page out of Mills Lane book there.
More of this is coming up after a break, so don't go away. The crunch of the Silverbacks.
A shoe for us. Damn.
This is about how you go to sleep one day, running your business the same way you always have, and wake up the next morning with things like email, voicemail, PCs, pages, a new communications network for free. It's not a fairy tale, a myth, or a parable. This is about how things can really happen. This is about opening your eyes instead of closing them, and making a call instead of a wish. Network MCI, that's how.
Nice job, Aikman. Real nice.
Inside each of us, there's a fire that drives us to be better.
Just a simple little screen pass, but you threw it like some kind of idiot. Ought to give all those people their money back.
But you have to feed that fire. That's why there's Metrics. A nutrient-dense, high-octane food for people who just don't know when to quit. Metrics. Keep the fire burning.
Hey, have you heard? Class is outside today.
Great!
There are plenty of places for college students to study.
Yeah, class outside.
All right.
Class is outside. Make sure you tell Miller.
However, some learning environments are more stimulating than others. To learn how you can earn college credit in the Navy.
Where's Miller?
I thought you told him.
I thought you were going to tell him.
And get up to $30,000 to finish your degree. Call 1-800-USA-NAVY.
Nice of you to join us, Miller.
Jesse. Jesse, you're next.
I'm all yours.
Save it for the stage, Romeo.
Carol always gives it to me straight. Like when she told me about my...
I told him about Head & Shoulders. Regular shampoos just rinse flakes away so they could come back. Head & Shoulders helps prevent flakes from even forming. You see the difference? You look great.
Thanks, but will it get me this part?
Couldn't hurt.
Head & Shoulders, because great hair can't have flakes.
Hey, break a leg.
Back at the Cincinnati Gardens, I'm Greg Mace. 8-5, the Cleveland Crunch have the halftime lead. Professional soccer, of course, has returned to the city of Cincinnati. The MSL will be coming up the road up in Columbus, Ohio. So it's given some of these youth teams something to shoot for. Now, these young ladies will not be playing in the NPSL or the MSL, but certainly it's provided them with a lot of inspiration. For the high school youngsters in the Ohio area. It's given them a chance for something to shoot for. So many NPSL teams have afforded the opportunity for these kids to get out on the carpet to learn the indoor game. And certainly it's a lot different than the outdoor game, but what a thrill for them it is to actually be out on this carpet and playing on some of the same fields where some of their heroes play. So it's a great promotional tool for all the teams around the NPSL. I'm sure these kids will enjoy the second half. Cincinnati's hanging right in there with Cleveland. 8-5 is our halftime score. The Crunch have the lead. Back with the second half and the Deuce coming up.
Whopper, 99 cents. Get your burger's worth.
Let's face it, people. Hey! Woo! Is the best player in the NBA.
Hey, Finnis! Is this Caspian leather? Because it's sticking to my leg.
We'll be right back. What else? Serious Blues. Who's the man with the coolest shoes?
The new Air Penny from Nike.
I guess Spike Lee wasn't available.
Fresh maker.
NPSL Indoor Soccer on ESPN2. It turns your living room into a rec room.
Rule number 45, board checking. Rule number 25, to play the game, use a puck.
The Sharks battle the Pens Saturday at 7:30.
The NHL rules on ESPN2.
There's your score as we get ready for the start of the second half. Cleveland had a lead of 8-2 at one portion of the game, and there's some numbers for the first half.
And surprisingly, the shots on goal favor Cincinnati, but we saw at least five or six of those shots go over the top of the goal. They're going to have to keep those shots down this half to beat out Orr.
Cleveland with a decided edge in blacks at 10-1. Good crowd at the Gardens. And it's showtime here for second half action. The Xavier University Musketeers play hoop in this building. Marinaro tries a long ranger. Rebound will bounce out to the midfield. Todd pokes it ahead. 2-on-1 developing. Medved couldn't get across to Thomas, but over and back will be called against Cleveland.
Cincinnati going to set up a restart here from the yellow line. They've got one restart goal on the game.
Medved's right foot. Otto got a piece of it with the dive to his right. And he'll look to distribute early. Crunch is so good at playing first-time early balls. They don't really mess around with it a lot in the midfield. Jimmy Glenn took it down, left it for Medved, trailing the play. A couple of Seattle boys right there, Medved and Schmetzer. Andy's been playing indoor soccer professionally for 11 years, and he's only 29 years old. 28 will turn 29 in April. He's a guy that was drafted right out of high school. So he could probably lend some tips to the Dusaski boys.
Few Seattle guys, few Canadians out there on the floor. Toronto is going to join the league next season, and teams are allowed to add Canadian players, Lyndon Hooper being one of them for Cincinnati. Hector Marinaro, a Canadian-born player for Cleveland.
Hector played with the national team Canada this summer for the first time in a good 10 years, I would say. 2-on-1 developing. Quick ball. Here's Miller right side. Blocked by Vincent Beck. goals in this game, Art, as we have one coming up.
Yeah, and you wonder how important restarts are. You see, all the teams with a winning record have a positive restart ratio. The losing teams all have negative restarts in the goal category, similar to turnovers in football. Very important part of the game.
And Cleveland, one of the deadliest because of this guy and the guy who almost got the ball, Hector Marinier. Played out by Jeff Alcala. That'll give the Crunch another restart, but not his team.
Well, Gary Hindley told us before the game they were going to put two players on Marinier on all restarts.
Get out of that mess. Schweitzer on an overlap. Moving it against Vincent Beck. He'll try a three-pointer. Just high and wide. Goody Harris off. So nicely taken down. Here is Zorin. Karich went over the 800-point mark in his NPSL career against Chicago on the 16th of December.
Cincinnati dropping back all the way to their own yellow line to give the defenders some support when Z has the ball one against one. Much better job than in the first half.
Two on one, the duo, Marinier scores! Hector Marinier with a two-pointer has put the Crunch ahead 10-5 as they get the goal at the 2:43 mark.
Well, great composure by Hector Marinier. Watch how he pump fakes once right there to freeze the goalie and then just curls it nicely into the upper corner.
Hector's first goal of the game. The Crunch have a 5-point lead. We'll be back.
Feel the heat. Catch balls of fire. Call 1-800-80-KICKS for the only scorching soccer action available on home video. Get ready to smash, crash, and score with balls of fire. No soccer fan can afford to miss this sensational home video. Cheer all the heart-pounding plays, the greatest goals, the wildest kicks, and all the outrageous antics of the game as you've never seen it before. Call 1-800-80-KICKS now for Balls of Fire, the hottest, fastest, and most intense sports video you'll find. Don't miss your chance to experience all the blazing action, cool moves, and explosive entertainment of NPSL soccer. Get Balls of Fire for only $14.95 plus shipping and handling. All major credit cards accepted. This video is available only through this exclusive TV offer. If you like your sports action fast, serious, and fun, call 1-800-80-KICKS now. Balls of Fire. Catch it.
Hey, Red Dog.
What?
Do you ever wonder why we're here?
Where?
You know, here. Why we exist?
No.
How come?
I got better things to think about.
But why are we the way we are? I mean, I'd give anything to be as big as you.
True. You ain't big, but you're real quick.
Quick? Yeah. I guess it all evens out then, huh?
Well, that might be pushing it.
Red Dog.
Hey, Red Dog.
Yeah?
Full moon tomorrow night.
I'm there, buddy.
College basketball. There used to be some on. That was okay. And then there's more. For a while, that seemed like plenty. But wouldn't it be cool if you could see more of the games you wanted? Your school's games. Great games in different time zones. Games with great new players. And hundreds of games you can't see anywhere else. Well, the ball's in your court. You just gotta contact your local cable operator or DirecTV, and they'll hook you up to ESPN Full Court. It's your season.
Hector Marinier scores his 24th two-point goal of the season. He's got 32 goals on the year. 84 points now for Hector. And I got a dynamic duo stat when we get a break, and there's an opportunity right now.
Cleveland's top three scorers, Marinier, Karich, and Miller, average 14 points between them. And they're at 8 points right now between the three through 2.5 quarters.
This is the Crunch's fourth year in this league, and since that time, Lyndon Hooper on his way. They got a fortunate bounce of the ball. Medved toe poke, Otto got a piece of it, and then it's cleared out. But since that time, the dynamic duo have combined for 624 goals and 1,674 points. goals and a lot of points. Not only do we have indoor soccer for you on the news, but we've got the other ball in net. Big Monday. Look at those games. Villanova and UConn. The Jayhawks in Oklahoma State. Fresno State and Utah. One night of basketball. Situation coming up here for the Crunch.
Too many restarts for the Crunch. This is their third one of this half, and if you keep giving them restarts, then they're going to kill you.
Chuck Codd looks to be the Silverback being checked out, I believe. Take a look and see what's going on in the NPSL as we're picking up the league about the almost the halfway point. Are some stats there.
The Crunch off to a Chicago Bulls type start, 17-2. Dayton now in Cincinnati. The Tampa team, they've been in a lot of close games. Kenny Cooper with his club down there. Brett Phillips for Kansas City has been outstanding in the nets for Zoran Savage. And the best coach, I don't know. There's some awfully good ones around the rest of the league. And what a job Keith Tozer has done in Milwaukee. Certainly the surprise team of this year, 11-3 mark.
They've got a couple of Canadians making big impacts in Milwaukee. Off the boards, Andy Schmetzer. And Pena was able to scoop it up. Carlos Pena actually has had some problems with a shoulder injury in the last couple of years.
Now, he plays almost every game, never comes out unless anyone else playing a goal. Simpson's his backup. He's only played in four games.
But I think Gary Henley plans to use more of Mark Simpson and Carlos Pena as a dynamic duo in the goal.
You would think so. Simpson's played in four games. He's got a 2-1 record. And considering they're 4-11, that's not bad.
Alcala with a quick step. He got around Miller. That's saying something right there. The quickness of Doug Miller. Tima and Miller crunched him there, but Medved came away with it, laid it up sweetly. Blakeman's left foot just wide. Back in. On the run is Medved. Crunch defense able to parry that away. Jeff Pop, 8-year veteran.
Pop out for his first shift. One of three former Dynamo players on Cincinnati's team now.
Squirted through in the curl with a goal.
Slow about the turtle there as he comes in and does his little turtle with his hands. But Alcala hit the initial shot off the near boards. He'll get the assist. And I tell you what, we got a three-point game.
Alcala with his first point of the season. Mark Thomas signed a contract with Cincinnati on the 7th of December. That is his 10th goal. He's played 8 games, and boy, did he make an instant impact.
And a gorilla sure loved the turtle.
First game with Cincinnati was Cincinnati's first win. He had a hat trick in that game. And he came back a couple of games later against Buffalo and had 7 points. Time of that goal was 4:49. And the Silverbacks, Jeff Pop with a long range, rocking that auto knock down to the rebound, unable to be stuffed home by Lyndon Hooper. Marinaro now breaks free, turned Pop around a couple of times, but Jeff recovered. Trigisevic follows up the cowboy, they call it.
And give Pop a lot of credit. His first shift out there, Hector Marinaro, one of the best players in the league, running at you one against one, and Pop did well to nick it away.
Lyndon Hooper stepped in again. Gary Henley feels Hooper's going to be a 40 to 60 point guy per year in this league when he starts to get his legs underneath him. Trailing Vincent's back left footer, he shot it in to the seats. And with that break, we're going to check in with Greg Mace. Greg, what do you got?
Well, here it is, one of the hottest selling logos in all of sports. It is the Cincinnati Silverback. What the heck is a Silverback? Here he is, the largest and strongest of all the male gorillas. This is Baxter. Oscar, the Cincinnati Silverbacks mascot, who will do anything to fire up the crowd. He's going nuts. And it's one of the best mascots in all of sports, if you can take him.
Hey, Mazur, make sure Baxter doesn't steal your hat there, as he's going after a couple fans.
It's a three-point lead for Cleveland. And what's turned out to be a great NPSL soccer match has been on the verge of blowout a couple of times. Gutierrez sweep. But the trailing help from Alcala.
Now you see Cincinnati get another goal here to make it 10-9, and Baxter is going to go bananas.
Oh, man. Across the fence, just behind Mark Thomas, was all by his lonesome. I think Art Kramer's been hanging out with Chuck Murr, the PR director of the NPSL, a little bit too long. Tried to thread at the carriage. White shirts all over. Early ball, Mark Thomas. Oh, just off the bench, Todd Nasoski. Hooper stepped in quickly. Medved in a race. Right footer over the crossbar. Thomas with time. Left footer missed. Hooper on the rebound. He shot it over. Thomas in front. He's taken down. We got a penalty kick coming up.
I don't know about that one, Ed. Cincinnati's inability to hit the target that led to this penalty kick. I'll tell you what, look at Hooper over the top. And then Thomas, yeah, definitely Otto grabbed his foot. I don't know if he had to, but the turtle was trying to make a turn. Otto came out with the right hand. And Henley's got to be feeling good inside. Cleveland's now going to have to bring on Jim Adams, their backup goalkeeper. And Ork's going to go to the box.
Tripping. This is worth 2 points. Should the Silverbacks put it in the net?
And give the referee some credit, Ed, for seeing that. That was a quick play right in front, and Otto definitely reached out with the right hand to pull down Thomas.
Scott Schweitzer thought he was getting the ball back to his goalkeeper, but the turtle was lurking.
Well, I don't know if they're close enough to hit the ball over the top from this spot, Ed. If they miss this one over the top, then Henley is going to have some things to say.
Talk about a tough spot for Jim Adams. He's been opening up the door for crunch players all game.
That's not fair in the points against average, coming off and having to face a penalty kick that your other keeper committed.
And no time elapses on the clock either. Adams doing the obligatory stretching.
And the obligatory crane, I'm sure, in the net.
Medved. He scores! And Adams got a piece of it. But that's a two-point goal in a one-point game.
And Adams upset with himself for not saving it, but he shouldn't be, as he guessed the right way, but the ball just slips under his left arm. You know, I'm not really in favor of trying to place those shots in indoor soccer from so close to range. I think power is generally more effective, but that one, just enough power to get under Adams.
The Silverbacks have made it a game. They trail by one in the third quarter.
Like a lot of other people, Alexi Lalas runs to work. The only difference is that when Alexi gets there, he doesn't have to change. Half running shoe, half soccer shoe. The equipment number 6 trainer from Adidas.
This week on Know It All, we present part 14 of Transportation, mankind's greatest challenge.
Dad, please change the channel.
Introducing the latest evolution in transportation, the world's first car multimedia system with LCD television and an in-dash cellular phone, which you control through a Clarion Pro audio system. Car multimedia from Clarion. It will enable mankind to conquer even greater challenges.
Are we there yet?
Like family vacations, Clarion, car audio and beyond.
Why don't you take the helmet?
I understand. Really not necessary.
Chicago
at 2 o'clock.
No, really,
I know it's an important press conference.
It's a nice gesture. I really do appreciate it.
I mean, that's impossible.
Susie.
Wait,
I can get you there in 10 minutes.
You can?
Yeah, come on. Gotta go.
I'm gonna need that. Sorry.
I don't know how you're gonna do this, but I appreciate it.
No problem. What's going on?
Michael, you parked in Chris Berman's spot.
I didn't know.
Come on, you moron!
Silverbacks have struggled through the fourth quarter of games this season. Henley telling them to play smart as Andy Schmetzer uncharacteristically knocks one into the seats. So look at Bruce Miller. His team has had a chance to really pile it on Cincinnati, and they haven't.
See Miller hoping that Cleveland can do what they've done all year long, and that's win on the road.
Medved's goal comes at 7:24, and Sean has 4 points tonight on a pair of two-pointers. Lyndon Hooper, score!
Take a T.O. here as Hooper with a three-pointer, and he did well, Ed, to stay over the ball that time. That one in the lower left-hand corner, and this place is going nuts.
A hat trick for the Hoop. Lyndon Hooper. 29-year-old.
He said, is that a three? You gotta be kidding me.
7:37, the time of Lyndon Hooper's third goal.
So they've seen a lot of different lineups throughout the first part of this season.
There's Hoop. Medved, a posting Thomas. Hooper couldn't get around it.
Probably should have hit that one with his left foot. Tried to toe poke with the right.
Blakeman went for the steal, came up empty. Marinaro slows the pace. A couple of Canadians in the corner. Blakeman on the defensive help. He can't get it past Todd Dostoevsky. Here's Todd. Three game-winning goals this year through the leg of Dragicevic. Medved slows the pace. Shot in a battle. Hoop spins out. Poked it ahead for Blakeman. And Troy Dostoevsky will get it back to Orr. one-timer. He didn't get a lot of it, and it was blocked partially by Alcala.
That was a great look at how Cleveland sets up offensively with isolating the two, Hector and Zoran.
Beck knocks it deep. Jimmy Glenn has scored some brilliant goals this year for the Silverbacks. Applying pressure, got help from Provan. And they draw a foul from Troy Desaski.
And Ed, it looks to me as if Cincinnati's the hungrier team at this point. And remember, Cleveland was stranded in St. Louis' airport for over 5 hours today, and they just arrived a little before game time. And some heavy legs starting to set in on the Cleveland side. This season in strong fashion, and with this man Mark Thomas up there with them, they provide a nice 1-2 punch for Cincinnati.
Mark Thomas recently surpassed the 250 point mark in his NPSL career. His first year in the league was spent with the Kansas City Attack.
And Thomas is a player that doesn't get a lot of credit. You don't notice him. He's not going to beat you with any flashy moves, but big, strong boy who likes to position himself in the box.
He actually played for Keith Tozer, I believe, with the Attack, and it might have been in Atlanta at the time. Gutierrez, 114 points last year in his rookie season. He's a two-time ACC Player of the Year at North Carolina State. Carlos Peña with the slingshot. There's the hoop. Medved. Thomas. Doesn't work that time, and Otto will scoop it up.
And you see Thomas that time getting in front of Otto, trying to deny him that quick outlet pass. Frustrated when his team is down and getting late in the game. You see Carriage giving the referee a little lip, and he needs to be careful not to get himself a five-minute penalty. We've seen in the past on the Deuce, the Z-man loses cool, and he hurts his team when he has to go to the penalty box. Goals in that game in the first half. Second half kind of disappeared for a little while. needs to make sure he concentrates the full 60 minutes when he's in there. But another good young player for the Crunch.
Ganser again. Played it a bit early. Marinero misread it. Blakeman comes away with it. Knocked it into space. Now Collins 3-on-2 for Cincinnati. Just wide. Near side. And the break for the Crunch. Back left to right. Carriage has the controls. Right side Marinero across. It got deflected. Oh.
Hector must be a prophet because he had his arms up and that ball was still 5 feet from going in the goal. He knew it had enough spin to get in there, but hey, the Crunch killing you on the counterattack. Cincinnati with a great chance at one end. Medved couldn't believe he didn't score. And then Z to Marinero. And watch Hector. He's already raising his arms. Yep, he knew it was in.
I meant to do that.
Once again, a little English here. Going in.
Unlucky for Jeff Pop, hustling back to get in that play and trying to stop it from across. The ball just didn't bounce his way. Marinero with a pair of two-pointers tonight for 4 points. He had 5 points against the St. Louis Ambush.
And when things get tough, that's when great players come through. And Cincinnati has the momentum up 12-10, and back comes Ian Hector to tie it.
Hector now has moved into a tie with Doug Miller, 86 points apiece on the Crunch scoring table. And we're tied at 12, under a minute to play in the third quarter. Thomas took it down, walked out by Schweitzer, across, Hooper got a piece, but not enough of it. There's the counterattack. Doug Miller, he's a left-footed player with the right foot, wide. By 5 feet. Carbonara's left foot. Blocked by Vincent Beck. Backed it to the midfield. Schmetzer Miller was leaning a bit too much right.
That nice pass that time by Schmetzer. He couldn't have set Miller up any better than that.
Timeout called by the Cincinnati Silverbacks. With under 20 seconds to play, there's the scores. Hector Marinero with 6 points this evening. And Lyndon Hooper, 3 goals. His last one, that big tray. Well, Art, when you look at the Cincinnati roster, not a lot of guys have played in Dayton.
There's only 3 left. There's Carlos Pena, Vincent Beck, Jeff Pop. Actually, Mark, these guys played previous to that, Simpson and Mers, but there may be something to having 4 letters in your last name for those guys out of the 5.
Some of the guys, well, Bono has 4 letters. Yeah. Bob has 4 letters, and those guys aren't around anymore. Some of the guys gone. Dennis Brose, who is an all-star big scorer, now in Detroit. Tony Bono is in Chicago. Other guys, Scott Cook, Phil Wolf, Scott Miracle, Chris King, Scott Lawler. I mean, they were a core of the Dayton Dynamos for a long time. They're no longer around with Cincinnati. And, you know, Gary Hindley told me, he said, you know, I think a lot of people are saying, you know, I wanted to put my stamp on this team. I wanted to mold it. And he said that really wasn't the case. I was just trying to fit a puzzle together, and sometimes the pieces just wouldn't fit, and I was doing it on the fly.
Well, Dayton was a team that went to the NPSL Finals 2 years in a row about 5-6 years ago. But since that time, they've struggled, and I think he just was trying to change the attitude there. Bring some winners in that he had from Cleveland. And it's just a matter of time to see whether that pays off.
You know, Mark Thomas, along with Sean Medved, Cincinnati's dynamic duo, have played against Marinero and Carriage a lot when they were together on that team in practice, first line against the second line. So that competition started a long time ago. 7 seconds. Hilly elects not to go.
There's a lane to Blakeman right there. You see it.
Trugicevic is starting to see it too.
And Blakeman certainly sees it. He can just play that ball. Blakeman doesn't even need to move.
I think there's the chip. One timer missed it wide. And Carriage tries a long ranger. Payne will take it. There's our horn. 3 quarters. And we've got an even game. Cincinnati with a big third quarter. 12-10 lead. They're tied as we go to the fourth. Don't go away.
Hartwick College offered getting the nod for the Heat. Drew Burwash at the other end of the carpet. for the Canton Invaders. Burwash has a 14.43 points against average. He is 0-3 this season. Todd Hofford of the Heat is 0-2 with an 18.24.